Hey, come on, let's potty. Sage. Go potty. Good girl. Uh-oh. So while I make my bed, I wanted to talk to y'all about the chapter I read and the book. Love just talks about the lovelessness in our society and maybe like the childhood trauma you might have endured and the ways we think we might know love but really don't know love, you feel me? Most of our first encounters and actual like loving relationships probably come from friendships, because it talks about like if you were abused at home or neglected or anything like that, that wasn't love that you received from, you know, that guardian, that parent, whoever it was that was doing that. Abuse and neglect cannot coexist with love. Like, there just was no love. You were cared for, they cared for you a whole lot, but that's just not love. You don't abuse somebody. And not to really just point blame at the guardian or the person that was watching you, because they probably endured the same thing where when they were growing up, they were treated the same way and they weren't loved. So how could they treat you with love if they never knew love themselves, you know? So it just talks about like ending the cycle and everything like that. But I don't want to get too deep onto it, but you know, I found a lot of my loving relationships and grandparents and in my friendships, and even with my boys now, it's like we genuinely have love, like love for each other. And like, it's deeper than a lot of most of my family connections, you know? So it's like, it also talks about like these friendships that you have, like not really trying to separate it. Like a lot of people be like, well, that's a friendship, you know, romantic love is way different from a friendship love. And in reality, it's not. Like, it's the same thing that you would have in a romantic relationship: respect, caring for one another, a mutual understanding, like things like that. Like, it's really no difference between a friendship and a loving relationship. Obviously the intimate part where you're fucking and whatnot, but as far as like, you know, the care for somebody and the true love, like the true love for a person, it's kind of the same. So it says you should definitely take those friendships and the way you treat those friendships, because it talks about like how you wouldn't accept abuse in most friendships. Like, you're probably in that friendship immediately if they put their fucking hands on you. But in a relationship, sometimes we feel the need to bear through that and stick through, you know, the bad times and the good times with a person. And it's like in a friendship that you experience real love in, you wouldn't do that. So why would you do that in a relationship, you know? And even sometimes when we see relationships in a different sense as like disposable, like, oh, if your needs are not being met, leave the relationship. But in a friendship, you wouldn't really do that. You know, you'll probably have a talk with your friend, like, yo, I want to see you more. You're hanging out with your girlfriend too much. Like, I want more time with you, woo, woo. Like, but in a relationship, sometimes it's too disposable in our mind and we'll just get rid of it and everything like that. So yeah, that's my little insight from the chapter I read this morning. That's why I said it's so important to just get your brain moving before you just got there and pick up your phone. So I always read a chapter a day just to get the brain awake and start my day right and maybe have something to ponder on, think about. Sometimes I'll talk to Kai about it when we read the same books and things like that. For any of my men or women that are watching this video right now, if you want to get into reading, this is my first year really diving into reading. I've read before, usually at low points in my life, but like right now, I'm enjoying reading so much. I would suggest getting a Kindle. Like, having a Kindle is like just a cooler thing to have than just like a paperback book. You can download more books. I like to know the chapter I'm on, how much more pages do I gotta read till the chapter's done sometimes. And it tells you all of that. So I don't know. I just think a Kindle's a great investment. And if you are having a hard time reading like paperback books or just getting into reading overall, I would say buy a Kindle from Amazon. They're like $99 and it'll be your greatest investment.
Workout complete. Got me a little lean body after the workout to goddamn just get the protein in as fast as possible. Still doing 20 minutes of Stairmaster. Then I do a 10-minute sauna after just to get all the toxins out and everything. The workout got interrupted talking to one of my partners, Greg, who moved out here. He was part of WP fam, a supporter and everything. He moved to come pursue content creation and everything like that. And he just talked about how like my story motivated him and shit like that and gave him like the push he needed. So that shit just be crazy to me, bro. That I don't know. Like, I know like y'all be listening to what I be saying, but it just hit different when like when you actually see it and like they tell you to your face, like, I'm here right now because you helped me type shit. Like, it's just crazy. But lean body, this is the second meal replacement of the day. 40 grams of protein in this guy. So about to throw this back, drive home, and then we'll keep the day going. Sage. Ah. Hey. Hey. No pull. Ah, ah. No pull.
Not the leash. Leave it. Yo.
If I come to you like this. Oh, yeah. Let's get it in. Oh, yeah. Let's get it in. Sick him. Get him, Sage. Get him.
So I gotta go handle some like top secret, personal, very, very personal business right now. I know it's a day in my life and you're kind of confused. Like, Nigel, bring us along. This is very personal. So y'all are gonna stay here. The guys are gonna watch the Super Bowl and y'all can see some content of that. You gonna record while y'all watch the Super Bowl? Get some clips. Nah, she's probably gonna lose some money. She'll be entertaining, all right? So make sure you get them right because big dog gotta go handle some business, you know? You think my personal matters are, this is like, good for that?
Mm-hmm.
It's gloomy outside. I heard this one dude say, like, when it's gloomy, he like to wear color, so he's the light. You know what I'm saying? Like, you get what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, I get what
when it's
on.
Gloomy, wear some color to make the day better. Type okay, shit. Okay. Out there, so make sure this motherfucker recording, because if I come back and you left them hanging, and they don't got nothing to fill the void while I'm gone for a couple of, you know what I'm saying? Mm. All right, y'all. I'm glad.
Yo, are we gonna go get the pizza or what?
I fucked up. I thought I ordered it. I didn't order it. I had to redo it. So now we're gonna miss the kickoff. Can you go get it? You take my car.
You're coming.
I'm gonna miss the kickoff, bro. I gotta see my dad.
What? Let's go.
I just wanna talk to my woman, bro.
What? Yo, don't be on that soft shit today. Your dad will not like that shit. Let's go, Najee.
Nigga, I gotta see dad catch the first touchdown.
No, you don't. Let's go.
Get this black girl off the screen. Where's Taylor? I wish Travis Kelce was my dad. The Big Yeti. Big Yeti.
That sounded like Chewbacca. I wish Travis Kelce was my dad.
Like. I literally will get trade dads. This team has get these thugs out of my face. Woo! The Big Yeti. Dad! This is a dynasty. Dad! I can't leave, Cam. I would literally pay you $10 to go get the fucking pizza. Just run! What are you pumping him for?
Oh yeah, 12.
Oh yeah, that's game! Bang! Fuck you! We fucking going home!
You're tight.
Fuck the Chiefs, fuck the Mahomes, fuck Kelce, fuck Taylor Swift, fuck fucking Jason Kelce! Jason, Travis, Brian, fuck the Mahomes, fuck his dad, fuck his wife, fuck his kids, too!
He's trying to come up with that money, look, he out! He out! He out! Ah! Don't jump!
Today, we didn't get to do everything we wanted to do yesterday. Bro, it's so hard for me to do like a full day of anything because like shit just comes up, you know? And the day got kind of away from us during the football and the personal business I had to handle and things like that. So I might show y'all the rest of the daily routine, like my true day routine. Yesterday was kind of obscure for me, but today, self-care day, you know? I'm gonna go to a couple of spots, do a couple of things. Me and Cam, just bring y'all along with us, you know? I feel like maybe y'all watching us get taken care of and pampered might make y'all feel like y'all are here with us, so you're getting pampered yourself, you know? First stop, Moss V Cuts. I must be losing my dreams.
Cut it off, it's too low, dang.
Cut it off?
Yeah, bro.
Really?
You feel sexy, bro, fuck it.
That's your final judgment.
Nah, you try it, bro.
Cut it or try it?
Nah, try it,
bro. Why do you look away? I hate when you do that shit. That means like, I'm gonna let you do what you want, but I'm, you know.
All right, look at me skate on. I can't see, turn your head.
I'm trying to see what's up.
Hey, look, you got enhancements on there? Oh, that's all you? You might be straight. You might be straight. Yeah, you might be straight, bro.
Sure.
I don't know what the hood's going to say. I say it looks great.
We have arrived at the post office. We at the back door. No.
See? That's y'all. That's us. Welcome Payne shit. Cascade Heights shit, man. Make sure you shop. Uh-oh.
Time
to get the
Girlie's done. Period.
Oh, hell no.
They be hurting though. They should be hurting. You know what ever hurts you?
They do hurt, man. I make noise.
So I take off my shoes now. Yeah, it's too hot for me. No cap.
Really?
No
cap. Well, you might have to do it first.
Put them here. Sure you want me to try it first?
I can try it for you.
I'm feeling like I want to dip one in.
Oh!
Yeah, a little too hot. Let's make it a little bit more cold. All right, a little bit more. Oh yeah, this is just right here.
All right. Still got found me. Understand that, still got found me.
I got the itis.
Give me a best heme impression.
Stop.
Okay, with your feet out.
Rich, he paid for the whole thing. Uh-huh.
Shit, no.
Mm-hmm. Yup.
You enjoying it?
I don't know. It smells like oranges. Tangy and citrusy.
Try to relax, Kev.
I was falling asleep, and I don't know if I'm the only one that this happens to, but like when you get kind of tired, you get kind of rocked. So, man, that was happening to me, and then she just kept like hitting you like with cold lotion. I hated it. I was just like, bruh, like I want this to be over already. Oh my god.
So you didn't enjoy it.
I enjoyed it, but I fell asleep. Like, I didn't want to fall asleep.
I think I fell asleep, too. Like, I was, like, I dozed off.
Like, I swear I heard myself snore, and then I was, like, like, I was falling asleep, and I was like that.
That's broke, fat, and lazy, and disgusting.
You fell asleep, too, so okay, you fat, lazy, and broke.
Okay, but snoring during a facial is some fat, nasty shit.
I didn't snore. I was like...
Ew! All right, so Cam keeps raving about this massage place. This is going to be a wrap of the night. Cam keeps on talking about this in a way that's like, what do you really mean by a massage? So, taking him there now, it's 5 minutes down the road. Maybe he gets a handy, maybe he gets a tug, maybe he gets, you know, hot coals on him. I don't know. We'll see. Should be interesting though. It was a good day though. I feel refreshed. I feel clean. I feel like, yeah, I got a good oil change in my body. I fly out tomorrow, going to Vegas. We're going there for business, and we're trying to find new manufacturers to work with overseas. So that's what we're going to Vegas for. So we'll record that whole process, obviously, everything like that. All right, my son, massage time.
Uh-huh.
Hydrating before massage? Okay. He's a little too chipper. I don't know, chat. Like, he's bucking with some conviction. Oh, hell no. I don't know, chat. I have a strong indication. He about to get right. He about to get, you know what I'm saying? He about to get taken care of in a different kind of way.
Hey, Cam. How's your massage?
Straight.
Rehydrating? How was it? It was good? You out of breath? You good? Got a little tuggy?
A little ta-ta.
You like a little tug?
A little ta-ta.
What was it, Art? You got a tug for real?
Yeah.
How was it?
It was cool.
Yeah? Tell me more. I want to know.
Oh, shit. I don't know. You just walk in the room.
Uh-huh.
I just started rubbing my ass.
Oh.
Like, is this a regular massage? Like, what's going on? Like, you
she
missing
fingered
my...
your asshole?
No.
I don't
was
know.
Rubbing, she was rubbing my back, and then she was like getting around my chin. I'm like, what the fuck? I was like, and then she was like, you want to turn over? And I was like, all right. Then she was like,
ah!
I was like, what the fuck? What type of freak shit you on?
Yeah.
Then after that, she was like, oh, are you blue? And I was like, this bitch must be asking if I'm a cop. I was like, no. And she was like, you sure? And I was like, yeah, I'm sure. So she was like, so tell me what you want. And I was like, I did a little one of these.
What? Oh!
Then she was like, and then she was like this.
What's that?
60.
Mmm.
So, I was like, all right, whatever.
Whatever.
So then, she put some shit on my, she started jerking my shit. She started doing a little pass, she was like, and she started. I was like, damn, bitch. So then she started getting an emotion. She was like, she started acting like I was fucking her.
Mm.
because I have my eyes closed because I don't want to look disgraced.
Like, you didn't want to watch her.
I didn't want to watch her. I'm like, because I felt disgraced. So then she was like, she started getting in the mold. So I got my hand behind my head. I didn't know this trick. I was like, one of these. She take this hand and put it on her ass. I was like, oh my God. So then I was just thinking, I'm like, what the
That's
fuck?
That's just
is
for
going
you, Poppy.
On? So then she really started getting emotional. And when I say she started getting emotional, she started, baby.
Yo.
I was like, I was fucking her.
Yeah.
And she started jerking my shit. Then I'm like, I'm not even about to nut. I just want to, I'm just about to make her look dumb. But then I was like, nah, I can't be here too long. It's starting to get embarrassing. So now I just did my thing.
Wait, well, how'd you log in? I mean, you did.
I just closed my eyes and I was just like, fuck it. I ain't gonna lie. When she started getting in the mood, started that moaning shit, that shit started getting to me. I ain't gonna lie.
Mm-hmm. You exploded everywhere.
Everywhere.
On yourself, on her, where?
On her. It was in her hand.
Oh, shit.
And she was like, oh my gosh, hold on. I'll be back. I gotta go get rag and stuff. I was like, I kind of understand 70% of the shit she was saying, so I need
you
a lot
like it
of
that
what
way,
happened.
I know your type. You love Asian women. Mm-hmm. Rated it 1 out of 10. 10 being the best.
Hey, 7.
Wow.
First time, so I don't really know what to expect.
This is just the start of this long list.
No. No. This is the first and last time. I really genuinely wanted a massage, and she tricked me. This is no good.
Yeah, I'm literally crying. Yo, let me see it.
What?
Huh?
Come on, dog.
Come on, dog.
This ain't the shit equipped with columns from my reckless swagging. This that dark house party with this record blasting. Rolling spliffs click beside me, fingers lip Arachi. When I seen this bitch and Ben and Tommy and Samir Harachi. I'm all alone, no.